In 1869, following the Civil War, Father Joseph Binn, pastor of St. Joseph Catholic Church, along with Mrs. Elizabeth Schaefer, a local widow, founded a community of sisters whose mission was to care for orphans and older adults. The sisters' mission to the elderly continues to this day, as St. Francis Home provides care to over 332 annually, and despite the turmoil of this economic period, it has maintained an occupancy rate of 88%. St. Francis Home provides short-term and long-term care in a setting that consists of all private rooms and focuses on delivering person-centered care. Mass and communion are available daily to those who wish to participate. The Sisters of St. Francis are a daily presence in the facility as they continue their historical mission to the elderly, offering assistance with activities and providing spiritual direction to anyone who wants it. St. Francis is one of the first nursing facilities in Seneca County to provide services and programs specifically designed for people suffering from Alzheimer's and other dementia-related diseases. St. Francis Home and staff strive to enhance the physical, emotional, and spiritual well-being of our residents by recognizing their individuality and providing them with opportunities to live full and satisfying lives.
The best part about working here is seeing how happy the residents can become. Because when they first come here, they don't want to be here. Most of them don't want to be here. So a big part of our staff's job is to make them feel comfortable. We have to become part of their family. You know, we have to learn about them and their family and what they like to do. And as much as we do that, they want to know about us and what we like to do in our families. And so it is hard. It's hard for the residents and it's hard for the staff. But they work together, and when we have staff that, you know, moves on or graduates school, and the residents are heartbroken because part of their family has moved on, we have staff that still come back and visit because they've built those bonds with those residents. And so they're just as much a part of their family as anyone else.
Today, St. Francis Home is home to residents whose ages range from 46 to 102 years of age, as the Sisters of St. Francis continue their ministry to all those in need of care. And at St. Francis Home, no one is ever turned away because of their inability to pay for their care. Let us take a moment to hear from our residents how St. Francis Home has made a difference in their lives.
I've been living here a little over a year. I've been to several other nursing homes, and I found out this one is the best because the living arrangements were much suited for what I wanted. And with the staff, they're very friendly, very cordial, and they go all the way out to help you wherever they can. And to me, it was wonderful because my wife was here. She lived here a little over 6 months and she passed away. And I had the funeral here at St. Francis. And to me, it was very nice because I could do everything from here. The staff helped. We had the funeral here in the chapel and it went very well. And I thought it was very nice.
I like it here. A lot of friends and a lot of things you can do. And I enjoy every bit of it.
I like it very much because everything is available here. You have your physical therapy, you have exercise classes, you have all kinds of activities. And I've been always on the go, so that suits me fine.
Because we're always doing something, planting gardens, things like that, and going to movies. And
you got computers here that you can work on. And
I do have somebody here that I play chess with, and
you name it, and we got it.
But the thing I like most about is the help. The help is so kind and understanding and obliging that it's just makes it a wonderful, wonderful place. I know it's not like home, but hey, I'm 87, so when you're that age, you have to give up something to survive, see?
I find that you can make friends here. I have made friends since I've been here, and it's been very enjoyable, really. We've had a lot of fun out of, in spite of the falls and the pain and the everything else.
But I'm very happy here. It's very nice. Everybody is very attentive, and the meals are good. I can't complain about the food because it's just, it beats Bob Evans or Wendy's or any place else. Yeah, that's for sure.
I miss my wife, of course, that we came together and we live pretty close together. She passed away and about 2 years ago. I really miss her. And we had a lot of fun together. I had heard a lot about St. Francis, you know, how they took care of their patients. And I wanted the same thing for us. So that's why I came here.
Blessed are those who make it known that our residents are loved, respected, and not alone. Blessed are those who, through love and care, ease the days of our residents' journey home in so many ways.
I've been a Sister of St. Francis for almost 56 years. And I've been in this position of pastoral care with our senior sisters, those that are here, residents at St. Francis Home, as well as Freedman Village. And I've been doing this for a little over 11 years. And these have been very, very special years. And we try to make this as good a life as possible for them, even though they're in the midst of aches and pains and minds diminishing. But we try to support them in their spirit and just who they are as people. One of our sisters who died a couple of years ago now, she was the dearest lady. She loved everybody, and she was a nurse, and she was helped move residents into this home back in the 60s. And she didn't let people forget that. She loved to tell the story about moving people from what is now our spirituality center to St. Francis Home. And for a while, when she moved over here, she thought she was in charge yet. And she wanted a desk in her room. Now, where is my desk? So we got her a desk and set it up like she was still in charge. And she was pleased with that. But of course, you know, she... She kept everybody alive over here. She was a dear lady. And she happened to be my teacher, and she would never let me forget that either, that she taught me in the sixth grade. At any rate, I've had many wonderful moments and times with our dear sisters. 43 of them, of our sisters, have died since I've been in this position, and I was with most of them at their time of death. That too is such a sacred time. You know, some of them when they're in just lots of pain and trying to work with the physicians and our staff here at St. Francis to keep them as comfortable as possible. Yet, I know one of them who just moved on to heaven this past year, lived in a lot of pain. But yet she had such a wonderful spirit of accepting that pain and said, you know, I just thank God that I can move and I can get out of bed this morning and I can pray. And she spent a lot of time in prayer. And that's also a very special experience or relationship with our sisters, is nurturing their spiritual journey, their relationship with God, but supporting the staff here who work and getting to know the other residents. And there are beautiful people here, you know, to really see the residents here as very sacred, good people, and who've come with years of life and experience. And now, at the end of this life, we try to make this a sanctuary, a place where they are reverenced, where they're honored, and where they're loved and cared for. And I feel like my ministry, I mean, I just feel like I have been so blessed. And I pray that I've been a blessing and continue to be a blessing for our sisters as well as other residents, families. And some days can be very hectic, and yet, you know, life is precious.
The staff is, I find, very, very helpful.
It's a wonderful place to work, and it's a wonderful place to be.
As I said, I was at several different other nursing homes, and this one has the best campus I have ever seen, which is very nice. I can go outside and be outside and not say I'm in a nursing home. It's the nicest thing. It's more like, it's almost like being in college, almost.
I think everybody in the building seems to know my name. I can't believe it, but it surprises me every day. They know my name. So that makes it rather very pleasant and easy to get along.
So I'm quite content to stay right where I'm at.
Regardless of one's income, regardless of one's assets, St. Francis Home exists to create a community where each individual can live their life fully. Today is your opportunity to make that difference, to show others you care.